Hi everyone, this is Katie from the Perot Museum of Nature and Science coming to you today from my kitchen. And you know how much fun it is to eat out? Well, this week we're going to eat in outer space, that is. So astronauts eat the same things we do, but their fruits and vegetables have to have all of the moisture taken out of them so that they'll last for a long time in space. So we're going to show you a couple of methods today to take that moisture out of your food. If you have a dehydrator, you can use that or the oven, or we're going to use some dry ice. Let's get started. Using whatever fruits and vegetables you have handy, I'm using a banana, strawberries, apple, and a pear. Slice them about 1/4 inch thick in nice, even slices. Arrange on a baking sheet. I'm using a rack so that they won't stick. And if you're using fruits that brown easily, dip them or brush with a little bit of lemon juice. Set your oven to its lowest temperature. Mine is set at 150 degrees Fahrenheit. If you have a convection setting, turn that on too. Dehydrating fruit takes about 8 to 10 hours. Try rotating your tray a couple of times for even baking. While we're waiting, let's try freeze drying. Put your fruit in the bottom of the cooler, cover it with the dry ice, and when the ice is gone, it's done. And now let's take our fruit out of the oven. Looks beautiful. And now everyone, we have a really special guest, astronaut Christina Cook, who was a member of the first all-female spacewalk team to talk about her experience eating in orbit. Bye-bye, everyone.
So today I'm going to show you how we make mac and cheese in space. First of all, you have to go to your pantry and pull out the mac and cheese. So for us, our food is kept in these containers that look like this. All of our food is either dehydrated or it's made thermostabilized so that it can be in a packet, almost like an MRE. So first we need to look for some mac and cheese. Mac and cheese is one of our dehydrated ones. Let's see if I can find it. No, that's rice. Rice again. Mac and cheese. Next, I'm going to show you how we open them up. Okay, so we have our mac and cheese here, like I said. And this is kind of like our kitchen area. Here we have our oven, kitchen sink, and refrigerator. A little bit different than what you're used to. So on the outer packaging of any of our dehydrated foods is just this to keep out light so the food sort of stays more fresh. Throw that away. And next we have our dehydrated mac and cheese. And we need to get some water in here, but we can't just pour water in because no gravity, it won't go down. So what we have is a system where we actually can eject water using our kitchen sink. This is a space kitchen sink, there's a little needle there, and it actually will puncture into this opening, and then water actually comes out of that needle. So I'm gonna put it on dispense. I'm gonna dial in how much water to dispense, which for the mac and cheese is 100 milliliters, so that's right. And then I hit the button. Now watch this. The water's gonna come in, fill out the packet, and see now that there's water in there. Now I need to get the water to go one end, so I go like this, clip it, all the water goes one end so that it can start rehydrating the mac and cheese. I'm gonna keep it warm while it's rehydrating. I'm gonna stick it in the space oven. I might mix it a little bit. Now we just wait. Okay, I'm pretty sure our mac and cheese is ready, so let's see how you go about eating. Oh yeah, that looks really good. Now, good thing it's kind of liquidy, because otherwise, as soon as we open it, it would just float everywhere. So the first thing you have to do is swing it again, get it all down at the bottom. Cut it open. We'll clean those later. I've got this, and we do have a special place where we put our trash that has some food on it, so it doesn't smell bad. And then we all keep our different silverware with Velcro on this little plate here. So you grab your own spoon, because this is going to be a little hot, so we have to wait for it to cool down a bit. Oh yeah, that's is pretty good. Luckily it stays on the spoon or else it would go everywhere. Real gentle so it doesn't flick off. That is good.